Alright guys, Diecast Mania here with a mall review of the Shinsai 150th scale Hitachi Zaxxas 350 LCK High Reach Demolition Excavator. So this is a very hard to find model. It's been discontinued for a few years already. Pretty expensive if you were going to buy one new. They usually go around $200 to $300 a piece. Settling around $350 maybe. Something like that. But it's a pretty nice model. So, here we go. I'm going to start with the body of the machine. Cab's very nicely detailed. It has nice top guard, falling objects protection. And it's supposed to be a front guard, but the previous owner removed that. The cab is a very typical Hitachi Dash 3 series cab layout. Very nice though. It's got the blue seat with the Hitachi on the seat back. Some nice details in there. Very nicely scaled cab. Looks great. Much better than the Ertl cabs. Got a little bit of a step here. It's almost like a small catwalk. And a small plastic handrail. Body's all metal. And I believe that's the same with the underpan or bottom of the body. So, as you can see, Zaxxas 350 LCK. As you can see, the K is actually an added on sticker. I have no idea why they did that. I don't know why they couldn't have just pad printed it on. It's beyond me. Looking around here, very nice paint applications. And this is actually a spare weight they can pull off, and there's supposed to be three pins to fill these holes. And this is actually a backup slash swing camera for the operator. So this is a plastic engine cover. It doesn't open. Got your anti-slip texture here. Got your diesel fuel port, stuff like that. And you got the other plastic handrail. This model is supposed to have mirrors, but of course they never came with them because I got this used. Let's get onto the tracks. The plastic, so they don't roll very well. As you can see, there's no tensioner on this, so it's kind of basic. But the undercarriage is nicely detailed. Got some nice tracks there. I mean, they're kind of, you know, they look good. They're not overly shiny like some companies. I mean, that's not really something to get upset about, but you know, they got some nice sag to them to make it look more realistic, as some companies, they have the tracks super tight, and I don't really understand that look. But here we go onto the business end of the model, the boom. Alright, so the bottom of the boom, the boom adapter, or the main part that's connected to the machine, you can lower it all the way down like that. So that's when you're picking up the booms, or when you're done for the day and you just want to put the boom down. So the boom's capable of going straight up in the air. So that's a nice feature. So you can actually reach a very high building. So this is a 35-ton machine, so it's not going to be used on the largest buildings, but typical for city use, you know, tearing down a few multi-level buildings. Alright, so the knuckle goes out like that, the stick goes out pretty far, come in. The booms are resin, so that's one thing to be careful of. I mean, it's not like a super fragile resin or anything like that. It's actually pretty durable, but you know, just be careful. Okay, and on the end of the boom is this shear. Rotates 360, opens and closes. It's resin as well. Got some nice bolt detailing around the rotation point. A nice movement to it. It's fed by an auxiliary line. very nice casting or mold for this model. All right, now onto the standard boom, excavator boom. Not too many models actually have interchangeable booms. I think the only one I can remember is like the KCX800. Other than that, not really sure. All right, so here's the boom, and just the boom stand with the standard excavator boom. So basically, you just take them. There's supposed to be a nub here, just hooks on, but the previous owner broke it off. So. Right. So basically, this is how I think you're supposed to put the boom on the boom mount. You're supposed to stretch it all the way out, I believe. So, it's just like this. I don't know. Seems to be the most prototypical way without resting on any cylinders or anything like that. Alright, so now onto this boom. Got some pretty nice detailing. Resin as well. Cylinders are really nice. You can pose it in a lot of different positions. That you can have it all the way out, and it's got this nice resin skeleton bucket on the end, so that's definitely a plus in this model. And of course the auxiliary line here, and plenty of hoses all over. So basically this is the review of the Hitachi Zaxxas 350 LCK made by Shinsei, 150th scale. Basically, if there's one thing that I would say about this model that really sets it apart is, one, it's got two different booms. Two, it's got special attachments on it that you really wouldn't find on a production model of any other make. And three, it's a really unique Hitachi model. You really can't... There's not really many Hitachi models on the market besides standard excavators. So this is a specialty one. And I'll just end the video putting it next to a 450 just for size. You know, they're not that far off. Of course, 350 is a bit smaller. But there you go. The Shinsei Hitachi Zaxxas 350 LCK. Thanks for watching. Bye.